Hey guys, Keith Brown, Tack Room Devotional. Welcome. I'm glad you're here. This week I want to talk to you about something that has caused a little problems in the church, but we're not here to cause confusion and we're not here to cause any division. But I'm just going to ask the Holy Spirit to reveal to us the truth, that we can walk in the truth. Why? Because the truth makes us free. Amen. Now, many times when we discuss this topic, it's caused division in the church. It's called the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Okay? And I'm just asking you to come with an open heart, open mind, and allow the Spirit of God to minister to you and to minister to me and give us revelation to the truth. So let's let Scripture do that. Let's go to 1 John chapter 1, and this is where John is baptizing Jesus Christ, okay? And it says in verse 32, "And John bore witness, saying, I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove, and he remained upon him." In other words, the Holy Spirit remained upon Jesus. "I did not know him, but he who sent me to baptize with water said to me, upon whom you see the Spirit descending and remaining on him, this is he who baptizes with the Holy Spirit. And I have seen and testified that this is the Son of God." So, this tells us a bunch of different things. But one of the things, obviously, it's telling John, by the Father telling him that when you see this happen, you'll know that it is my Son, that this is Jesus Christ, this is the Messiah, this is the Savior of the world. But notice also it tells us that he is going to baptize us with the Holy Spirit. So that's what we're talking about this week. Okay, now if you look at Matthew chapter 3 and verse 11, Matthew chapter 3, and verse 11 says, "I indeed," and again, this is another account of John baptizing Jesus. This is from Matthew's account. "I indeed baptize you with water unto repentance, but he who is coming after me is mightier than I, whose sandals I am not worthy to carry. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire." The Holy Spirit and fire. Now, one thing that we need to know about fire, well, first of all, fire purifies, but fire also destroys. And so this is saying that Jesus is going to baptize us with the Holy Spirit, but also he's going to baptize us in such a way that it's going to cause us either to be purified or it's going to destroy us. In other words, this is something that this is something that's going to change our life. Amen. Very important that we know that. Here's something that happens after this. I want you to know this. Jesus, to this point, has not performed any kind of miracles. No signs and wonders. Yes, he did teach in the temple when he was 12 years old, and all the Sadducees and Pharisees were amazed at his understanding of Scripture. But no place in the Bible does it say that he performed any miracles. It wasn't until after his baptism, they then went to Cana, it's C-A-N-A, they went there, and that's when they were at this wedding, and they ran out of wine, and his mother said, you know, let him tell you what to do. And he said, bring me the water you have. And they brought the water and he turned the water into wine, right? That was the first recorded miracle that Jesus performed. But notice it was after his baptism, after him being the Holy Spirit descending on him and remaining on him. So that is kind of the basis that we want to look at, because, you know, whenever you have questions about your own life and what's going on, if we look to Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith, we can get a better understanding of what happened with him. Now remember, he is 100% God, but he's also 100% man. So he said, I don't do anything under my own authority or under my own power. I do only what I see the Father doing, and I say only what the Father says. In other words, he was telling us, I'm going to live my life so that you can see how you're to live yours. Listen to the Father. How do we listen to the Father? Through the unction of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And so Jesus is showing us this. He didn't perform anything until he received the Spirit of God landing on him or descending on him and remaining on him. Okay, look over those scriptures, read them, but also pray about it, and we'll see you again tomorrow. Remember, Jesus loves you. I love you. I pray that God would richly bless you as you diligently seek Him and serve Him.